Hey guys, I'm here with my friend Kim LaRouche. She was Drew's preschool teacher, but long before that, she was my friend. And so we're just gonna talk today because she was one of the very first people to actually help me be able to get things accomplished with Drew's diagnosis in the beginning. So Kim, do you wanna tell a little bit about your relationship with me and your relationship with Drew?
Jennifer and Leo and my husband John and I have been friends for a really long time. And to a point that it was a personal, friendship where they would come over to our house. We would go to their house. We've always been really good friends with Jennifer and Leo and her family. And then along came Mr. Drew. And he was precious from the day that we met Drew. He's just part of our family. I mean, they are part of our family.
So can you tell me, when is the first time you think or you thought to yourself that Drew might have something going on?
I think it was around when he was around 2 years old. They would, come over to the house, and Drew's always been very, very, very smart. But I noticed, even at that age, that he could read words. He could walk around the room, and he could point to different, anything sitting around and tell us, what it said. He could sit there and, draw letters and make letters at 2 years old. And so I would compare him to, my kids, and he was way, beyond even, what they were doing at that age.
But even though he could read the words, he actually couldn't talk to you. It was more of a repeat.
Yes, that's exactly right.
Yeah.
We would say something, and then he would repeat what we would say. Just a lot of verbatim to what we, the conversations that we were having, he would repeat, the part, bits and pieces of what we were saying.
When we first were told what that was, they told us it's called echolalia, where he would repeat just what he had mimicked or heard. And sight words were easy for him because he knew what the word said in his head, so he could say that one word, but he couldn't piece anything together. There was no saying mommy or daddy. There was no I love yous. There was none of that. And how did you feel about seeing some of those and knowing there was something going on, and as far as being able to say something to us?
Well, because I knew that you guys would trust, my belief on, what was going on, because we were, such close friends. So I felt like because we are such good friends that I needed to share, because I've taught preschool for many, many, many years. But I felt like that because, I owed that to you guys, to be honest with you, that I should share my feelings about Drew.
So because Drew was preschool age when I was thinking that something was going on, you had actually told me that he was eligible for testing through the cooperative to see where he placed for preschool. Is that something that's available to people in the public if they're considering preschool for their child?
Yes. You and I had talked about the concerns, and the concerns was coming, from you to me, and so that was considered a referral. So that's when I contacted Suzanne to make the connection between you and Leo and Suzanne. That way we could get him tested and get, the process going even quicker.
Well, I've said it before, but I'll say it again, that we owe early diagnosis to the cooperative team and all that they provided for us as far as an educational diagnosis. Suzanne, Kelly, and Mandy, and you, really, we wouldn't be where we're at, and we wouldn't have the early intervention program that we did. Everything just fell into place because you guys took the initiative, and Kelly would meet me at McDonald's and was doing testing with me and going over things and just going way above and beyond to try to meet me where I could meet her on my lunch break. And you guys were just amazing. I really mean it. I don't know where we'd be without that team. Okay, so when Drew first started preschool, he could only go half days, and I was wanting you to talk a little bit about what Drew was like during that time.
Okay, well, when Drew first started preschool, it was a little too much for him. The kids were very overwhelming to him, as loud as they were in the classroom. It would hurt his ears. He would have a really hard time like staying in line with us, or like even going to the bathroom, going into the, you know, the stall and shutting the door. It was very overwhelming. It was very traumatic to him. When he would hear a toilet flush, he would cover his ears and start screaming. It was too much for him at the very beginning. So we decided that we would do half days to get him kind of worked into the preschool environment and not have it so overwhelming at one time.
Yeah, I can remember taking off at lunchtime, and I would drive out and I would read him a social story about going to the bathroom. And we did that, I think, for 2 months before he even would just walk into the stall and agree to even try to use the bathroom. I can remember that being a process getting there. I can also remember that you guys were just concerned that he would never get past that point, you know, and it was going to be very difficult for him to stay in the classroom without achieving the potty goal. So
yeah, well, we knew he would be going to kindergarten eventually, and that was our responsibility to get him ready for kindergarten. We had to do anything that we could do to make him successful. So whether, I mean, it being half days at first, then that's what we had to do. We had to work, take little steps along the way to get him where he is.
Yeah. Okay, so what is your hardest moment with Drew and your best moment with Drew?
I think my hardest moment was I felt frustrated because I felt like, you know, it was my job to make him successful, and we had some days that were really hard days, you know, and so whenever you would text and ask how Drew's day was, you know, I had to be honest, and there were days that were very hard with Drew, and I wanted to help fix the problem, but you know, there was just different things that we had to work through to get to that, you know, to that point. And I felt like, you know, there were some days that I felt like I was doing as much as I could, but it just wasn't enough. And then I would have to share the information with you guys. And it hurt my heart to have to give you bad news, you know, on certain days.
Right.
Because I always wanted it to be positive, and there were days that it just wasn't.
Right.
So...
All right, and your happiest?
I think the happiest time was when we had preschool graduation at the end of Drew's preschool, his 2 years, and he was going on to kindergarten. It was the graduation ceremony when he was standing up at the end, and he was standing by me because we were afraid that he might try to get off the stage. He never tried to get off the stage. He sang the whole time. He was the loudest kid out of the whole class. And he was the entertainment, basically, and because he was so successful from beginning to end, it was such a huge difference in Drew, and he was singing as loud as he could sing, and so happy. He was having a great time, and that showed me that he, you know, had come so far in those 2 years that he was in preschool.
At the end of preschool, would you still say Drew was very limited on what he could achieve by himself? Still mostly communicated with echolalia, which is just repeating what you had said. Even if he could do the things he was saying, just like you said, singing the song, it's a repeat of what he had heard. But that was still a huge challenge, but it was such a huge difference from the beginning to the end. Would you say that's pretty accurate where he was?
Yes, I mean, he still repeated a lot, you know, what we would say he would still repeat, but that came from him being nonverbal, basically. So, but we knew, you know, he was going to kindergarten, and they would follow through, you know, they would keep that process going. But still, I mean, to see him be able to go to the bathroom, you know, in the bathroom stall, and to walk in line, you know, with us, and to basically, you know, keep up with his classmates for the most part, you know, by the end of it. But we knew he had, you know, challenges ahead of him. But we also knew that we had done, you know, we had tried to do everything that we could do to make him successful.
Would you say that having Drew as a student in your class changed your perspective on what was possible to achieve with autism?
Oh my goodness, Drew made a huge impact on me. Drew was probably one of them that he just loved everybody. He loves every kid in the room, and he loved his teachers, and he didn't let autism hold him back for 1 second. He always was so happy when he came in. I mean, to me, it just goes to show that kids that have disabilities sometimes are just, you know, they're just so happy. And Drew made me happy, you know, when just watching him, you know, singing and giving hugs to the other kids eventually and hugging, you know, his teachers. And it just showed me that kids with autism can have so much love, you know, and they're just so happy that they're just so much happier than people sometimes without disabilities.
Right. Well, we appreciate you taking the time, Kim, to talk about it. And I hope that anybody who is approaching the possibility of their child having autism has somebody like you to help them like I did. And that they have a team as awesome as the team was that I had when we started. And I know that Drew will never, ever, ever forget his time with you. And that in the years to come, he will always be talking about his Miss Kim and how much he loves her. Hey, Drew, I would like to ask you, do you remember anything about preschool?
Hardly anything.
Do you remember your Miss Kim?
Of course I do.
Yeah, and do you remember how much she loved on you and how good they were to you?
I sure do.
Is there anything you'd like to say to Miss Kim?
I want to say I thank her that she was my preschool teacher.
Yeah?
When I was a preschooler, I thank her for that. I also thank her for loving on me throughout these years and still remembering me as a good student.
It's awesome. Love you, Drew.
I love you, Mom.